You always have to be looking down.
See, we're getting more and more species that associate with ginseng. This one here, this is Virginia snake root, or some people call it sang find. See how it's really pointed here? It's pointing toward ginseng. And it works. It's never wrong. Sometimes you have to go 300 miles, but it's never wrong.
Ginseng has been a very important part of many cultures in this part of the world. A lot of people that have grown up in this area have a multi-generational legacy of harvesting ginseng.
North Carolina is an incredibly biodiverse region. We have some of the highest vascular plant diversity in North America.
It's probably the best place in the world to grow ginseng. Just a great climate.
The plant has been very popular in the medicinal plant trade since the 1750s.
In the Appalachian region now, a big money item rather than just a traditional item.
It has always been a cash crop, so to speak, in Western North Carolina. Probably 90 to 95% of wild harvested goes to the Orient.
They want the wild harvested, stressed out roots. They're far, far more valuable, exponentially more valuable.
It's upwards of $1,000 a pound for dried ginseng roots. So that combined with our economic downturn has sent a lot more people, I think, out in the woods looking for supplemental income than in the past.
We're seeing a different type of collector now, who might not know and respect the plant and the habitat as well as some of the people who grew up here in these forests.
There's just not a consciousness that we have to reforest, we have to replant. The consciousness is take, take, take. Take as much as I can, as fast as I can, because if I don't take it, the other guy next to me is going to take it.
Harvesting ginseng is a destructive process because they're digging up the root, which effectively kills the plant. But digging up the plant in June before it's had a chance to produce seed that year is really not sustainable.
It's always suspicious when an individual on the first day of dry season in September comes in there with 10 pounds of ginseng. That's just impossible physically.
They're asked the question, is this your land that you've taken this ginseng from? And everybody says yes.
So one thing that we're doing is developing some dye for us to mark some of our protected plants. And so this dye is a yellow dye. It also fluoresces under ultraviolet light and has a magnetic code with a unique number for that site.
That product is made to grow into the rings on the ginseng and stain it. When if we think that they have hidden the markers in some way, we have canines that go in and sniff that marker.
See him scratching? There's dye on that root.
The high price on its head at this point is going to make it more and more rare in our forests. And we would love to develop a program to be able to distribute seeds so that we know that people are replanting with native accessions.
And I think that if we can work with people to develop the market for cultivated ginseng, that could ease the pressure on the wild populations. I don't know, it's a beautiful plant. It grows in beautiful places, so I hope that we can find a way to keep it sustainable.